ex-fiancé cheated on me, and then asked what she was entitled to, from my mom's house. Buckle in, kiddos, this is gonna be a weird one, obligatory too long didn't read at the end. So in my late teens I met a girl who I swore was the one. At the time, she was the first girl I ever dated that I had an actual real relationship with. I was young and very naive. She was the first girl I ever said I love you to. And I thought that meant it was a forever deal. Things were awesome for a couple years. Then, she started a second job at a liquor store to make some extra money so that she could afford to buy a car and start thinking about moving out of her mom's place. Admirable, I thought. I totally supported her on that one. I was still living at home with my mom, and the construction job I worked at definitely didn't pay enough to move out and afford a car. With her working two jobs, though, we could definitely afford a place of our own. After a few months of working this liquor store job and one robbery that a guy punched her in the head, she started acting different. I chalked it up to the robbery incident. That messed her up a bit. It didn't ring any massive alarms, but she had bought a car and started giving one of her male co-workers rides home after her shift was over. I thought nothing of it. It was what it was. I found out from not only her co-workers but her best friend that she had been cheating on me with this guy once they left work. When I confronted her about it, she cried and denied it. I was in love. I believed her. I just thought it was jealous rumors. A friend of mine brought up going to Mexico for a trip with the guys. I had never been on a plane before, let alone been out of Canada. So I was all over that. I had a bit of money saved up from work, so four of us went, without my girlfriend. While in Mexico, I cheated. I feel so bad about it to this day. But back then, 15 years ago, I guess I was just trying to get back at her. When I got back to Canada, I felt so guilty that I went right to a jewelry store and bought an engagement ring. So stupid. Yes, I Chandler Binged it. She said yes, and life was all good again. We were engaged for a year and a half. She was still living with her mom. I was still living with mine. During this time, she broke up with me four times over the dumbest stuff. She came over to my place once, and her clothes weren't dry from when I had put them in the wash. Close, but not quite. She opened up the dryer, grabbed her clothes, and stormed out. She dumped me when she got home. That was the first time. I was crushed. It happened a couple times after that, but they weren't that serious. I wasn't worried. Things went okay after those three times. The final time we broke up, I was out of town on a business training course. I called her from my hotel on Valentine's Day, asking how she wanted to celebrate. We need to talk. That's how she started every breakup. By this point, I was done. She said she didn't know if this is what she wanted with her life. Yada yada. I agreed. I didn't want a girl who was going to break up with me every time she was upset. I told her to come over when I got back. Bring me the ring, and I'll give her whatever she left at my mom's place. Simple. Yes, not so much. This is where she goes stupid. She shows up to my mom's house with her mom in tow. She gives me the ring. I hand her some clothes she left, some shampoo, and a copy of The Notebook on DVD that I paid for but didn't want. She looked confused. I asked her what the problem was. She dead-ass looked me right in the face and said, "Shouldn't I get more?" I thought I misheard her. I asked her what she meant. "Well, we were engaged, so I should get more stuff. I'm entitled to half, right?" I burst out laughing, not even kidding, as heartbroken as I knew I was going to be over the next little while. That was the moment that I had zero love or respect for her. We talked for a bit with her mom. Nobody else was home at my house, who also thought that she was entitled to more than her belongings. After about 5 minutes of them pointing at things in my mom's house and saying they want it, I kicked them out. My last words to her and she stood by the front step looking like she wanted to fix things was, "Bye, good luck, you're gonna need it, both of you." Bullet successfully dodged. Wow, to this day this still floors me. How the duck do you think you deserve my mom's belongings, especially when we don't even live together? Epilogue: I still talk to her mom and her brother once in a very blue moon. My ex is now a fentanyl addicted prostitute who is in and out of prison and living on the streets. When we were together, she was mildly straight edge, even refused to try pot with me, and rarely drank. When her brother tells me stories of finding her sleeping in alleys and complaining about the government spraying meth in the air to kill homeless people, it floors me. She also talks extremely ghetto, which is also weird because she was pretty proper when we were together. I always wonder what would happen if I saw her working a street corner. At this point in my life, I'd probably feel nothing but pity for her. That's about it. I still can't fathom how the hell she went, left as hard as she did. Unfortunate. Too long didn't T. Reed got engaged super young to a girl I thought was the one. She cheated. I cheated. I still lived at my mom's. She still lived at her mom's. When we split up, she and her mom thought that because we were engaged, she was entitled to my mom's property. Edit fixed some typos. Also, thought of a hilarious tidbit that I figured I'd share. This girl could not drive. She bought a piece of shit car, a maroon colored Passat, and drove it for maybe a month before she crashed it. Her insurance company got her a rental car, which she proceeded to drive into a pole in the first week. They refused her a rental after that, I believe. When she got her car back from repairs, she drove it for maybe a little over a month and crashed it again. After that, her insurance company raised her premiums so high that even Bill Gates would rethink mass transit. She had to park the car after it got repaired the second time. It sat outside of her mom's townhouse for God knows how long. A friend of mine that lived across from her told me that she saw my ex almost every night come home from work, start her car, sit in it for a while, shut it off, then go inside. At least she wasn't crashing it anymore. Cheater karma edit. So this story just came to me while I was thinking back to the whole liquor store fiasco. So after I called her out for cheating and we made up, we went to a boxing event. Tanya Harding was in town boxing a local girl. It was hilarious. The local girl punched Tanya in the face so much, but it was Tanya's reaction to getting punched that was hilarious. So after the event, we cabbed to the liquor store she worked at to pick up beer. The guy she cheated on me with was working the till. My ex was hammered. As we were paying for the booze, my ex fell down and ripped a gigantic fart. It was heinous. I tried to pick my ex up, but the smell hit me like a brick. Hot, thick, chewy fart stink. Good lord. It wasn't quiet, either. I picked her up and looked at the dude. He had the most disgusted look on his face. Chew on that for a while, ducker. Annoying. Long time later edit. I'm getting a lot of heat calling me an idiot, saying everything is fake. All good. I met this girl a little over 17 years ago. I was a very different person back then. I absolutely regret cheating on her out of immaturity, and obviously I wasn't ready for a real relationship at that point. No matter how much I thought I was, as far as proof goes, I'd be more than happy to talk to a mom to give whatever proof I can. I'm not sure what I can give that will stop people from calling bullshit on this, but I can try. Hit like. If you enjoyed this video, consider subscribing to our channel.